Hello students, we are discussing the methods of expressing concentration. Okay, in last video we came across weight by weight percentage, volume by volume percentage, weight by volume percentage, ppm and mole fraction we already discussed. Okay, now let us discuss sixth one. Okay, methods of expressing concentration. In that sixth one, molarity. Okay, you should be very careful. This is a molarity. Okay, now let us define. How can you define? Means it is defined as the number of moles of solute in 1 liter of solution. Okay, number of moles of solute present in the what? 1 liter of solution. It is represented by what? We have the letter what? Capital M. Okay, now molarity, nothing but capital M. Okay, why? Because me in the numerical directly they will mention 1 m, 2 m, means 2 m means what? 2 molar. 1 m means what? 1 molar. You should be very careful with the doing numericals. So now molarity, nothing but how can you define? Number of moles of solute divided with the what? Volume of solution in liters. Okay, this is the formula for the molarity. Now let us see here. So simply I am going at m equal to n by v. V I am taking in the liters. Okay, if you want in the ml means you have to multiply it with the 1000. So while doing the numericals you should be very careful. Volume, are they given liters or ml? If it's given ml means n into 1000 you have to do. If liter means directly you have to do. Okay, now let us discuss the numerical problem. This again I am taking from the stoichiometry. Okay, so let us see the numerical first. Okay, what is the given here? Calculate the molarity of sodium hydroxide in the solution prepared by dissolving 4 grams of enough water to form 250 ml of the solution. Here what is the volume given? Ml. Here we have the 4 grams of sodium hydroxide is there. Solution means what is that given there? Here we have the means you are going to prepare one solution. In that you are added the what? 4 grams of sodium hydroxide for what? 250 ml of water. Okay, volume how much? 250 ml of water. Okay, now this is my what? Solute. This is my solvent. Okay, now I am asking the what is the concentration of the what? Molarity. After adding this one, what is the concentration of this solution? Okay, now we have to calculate the molarity. Now so let us see the data here. So solute, what is we have sodium hydroxide, that is 4 grams, and solution here we have the total. Yeah, you should be very careful. This is a this is a total volume of solution. Okay, not the only solvent, solution. Okay, I told just now this solvent, no, this is solution. Total volume, how much they already told, finally they given the solution volume, how much? 250 ml. okay, so ml. okay, this is a not the total, this is a not the only volume of water. Okay, this is the total volume of our solution. Okay, this is the total volume of solution. Okay, now what we have to calculate? Molarity. Okay, now they are asking the molarity. Molarity formula, what we have? N by V into 1000. Why? Because I took the 1000 formula. Means here I told, if once you have the ml, volume in ml means you have to select this formula. Okay, so here we need the number of moles of solute. Are they given here formula? No. So first you have to calculate number of moles of solute, nothing but sodium hydroxide. So number of moles of sodium hydroxide is equal to mass by molar mass. What is the formula we have? Mass by molar mass. So mass, how much we have here? Already given the 4 grams. Molar mass, you have to calculate default. Okay, you have to remember. Why? Because my sodium is 23, oxygen 16 plus hydrogen 1 means you are getting the what? 40. This is what? 40 grams per mole. Okay, so if you go for simplification, number of moles of sodium hydroxide, how much you are getting? 0.1 mole. Okay, now number of moles of solute already we got. Now substitute here, 0.1 mole into 1000 divided with the what? 250 ml of water. Okay, already ml we have. Now if you got some simplification, how much we are getting here? 0.4, this is what? ml per ml per ml. Okay, now this this mole per ml, can I go for the replacement with the replace with the molarity? Why? Because means if you see here units, if you see here number of moles means mole per ml, nothing but equal to what? Molarity units. So 0.4 m, the concentration how much here we have? 0.4 m. Let us see the another example, numerical problem based on the molarity. Calculate the molarity of a solution containing 5 grams of sodium hydroxide in 450 ml of solution. Okay, again what we have? 5 grams of solute is there, 450 ml of solution is there. Okay, this problem you can see in the intermediate second year test book, problem number 2.2. okay, for the sake of information. Now see, solute was sodium hydroxide, how much we have? 5 grams. Okay, solution value how much we have? 450 ml. So once we have the ml means which formula we have to use? This formula into 1000 formula we have to use. So now molarity equal to n by v into ml into 1000. This is 1000, not the 100. Okay. Now, so for the first, we have to get number of moles of solute. So number of moles of solute, nothing but sodium hydroxide equal to what? Mass of solute already given, how much? 5 grams divided with the what? Molar mass of sodium hydroxide, how much? 40. 40 grams per mole. If you go for the simplification, how much you are getting number of moles of solute? 0.125 mole. Okay. Now substitute here. 0.125 moles divided with the volume of the solution. How much we have? 450 into 1000. So if you go for a simplification, we have how much here? This should be here. Mole should be there. Okay. Mole per ml. Okay. So here 0.278 mole per ml are 1 liter equal to 1 decimeter cube. So already we given this relation, the states of matter introduction. So instead of 0.78 mole per decimeter cube, already you can write, okay, or you can write it decimeter minus 3. Okay, indicate means it is, if you go numerator, you will get the word decimeter minus 3. Okay, decimeter cube, this is what. Okay, simply you can write 0.78 molar also. Now let us discuss seventh one, methods of expression concentration. We have molality. Okay, previous one is molarity, this is now molality. Okay, molarity we are going to show with the symbol word small m. That is what molarity we are showing with the capital M. Now this molarity with what? Small m. So how can you define it is? It is defined as a number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. Here we have take the only solvent, that too in the what? 1 kg. Previous molarity we talk in the what? Solution we took. But here what? We have take the only 1 kg of solvent here. So it represent with the by what? Small m. Now how can you define molarity equal to number of moles of solute divided with the what? Mass of solvent in kg. You have to take only in the kg. Now let us see the example here. The molality, you should be very careful in the numerical, are they given molarity or molality. Okay, the molality of a solution containing 60 grams of glucose. Okay, already they given molecular weight or molar mass of glucose as 180 grams. Okay, in 100 ml of water given by, so they already given the what? Here they given the water, how much they given? 100 ml of water they given. What we have to calculate molality? Now let us see here. Okay, so what they given here? We have the 60 grams of glucose is there. Okay, 60 grams of glucose we have. They added in the what? 100 ml of water they added. 100 ml of water they added. Okay, now what we have to calculate small m. Okay, to calculate small m, what we need in the here? Number of moles of solute and mass of solvent in kg we need. But here what they given? In 100 ml volume they given. But what we need? We need the mass, not the volume. So now you have to find out the what is the mass of 100 ml of water. Then you have to calculate the number of moles of glucose. Then go for the calculation of molality. Now let us see here. So first I am going to calculate number of moles of glucose, nothing but solute. Why? Because means what is the formula we have? First number of moles of solute we need. Now in this case glucose is my solute. So number of moles of glucose equal to mass by molar mass. Already we, how much we have here? 60 grams of glucose is there. So 60 grams by divided with the what? Molar mass of glucose, how much? We have 180 grams. Okay. Now if you calculate here, the diet I'm going to substitute here. Okay, this number of moles of solute. Now next solvent is for water. How much they given? 100 ml given. But according to formula, what we need? We need in the kg, not in the ml. So you know, as we know very well, for water density, how much we have here? Density is equal to 1 gram per ml. You should be remember. Okay, so density of water, how much we have? 1 gram per ml. You have to remember. Why? Because means we need the mass of water, not the volume. So density is equal to mass by volume. So here already we have density, how much here? Density formula, mass by volume, that is ml. Okay, you have to take the volume of ml. So gram per ml, density of water, density is equal to 1 gram per ml. So density equal mass by volume. So density of water, how much we have? 1 gram per ml. Mass you have to find out. Value how much given? 100 ml. The ml going to get cancelled. So now you are getting the mass equal to 100 grams. This is about 100 grams. But according to formula, what we need? Mass of solvent in kg. So now grams I am going to convert as a kg. As you know very well, 1 kg equal to 1000 grams. I want 1 gram nothing but what? 1 by 1000 kg. So simply you are going to multiply 1 by 1000 kg. So if you go now substitute here formula, molality equal to number of moles of solute. Okay, this is number of moles of solute. Mass of solvent, here if you go further, divided with the how much here? 100 divided by with the 1 by 1000 means, if 1000 you undergo numerator, so finally you are getting the what? 3.33 molar. Okay, this is what molal. Okay, molal means molality. Molar means molarity. Okay, here you should be very careful when in a numericals what they mean. Molar solution. Molar solution means. Molar solution means they given the what molarity. They given the molarity. Okay, molar solution means they given the molarity. Molal solution if they tell molar solution. Okay, molar solution if they tell they given the what molality. Okay, molality. Molar solution means molarity how to take. Molar solution means molality how to take. Okay, this should be very careful with the between the numericals. Now let us discuss. 8th one, normality. Okay, normality, this showing with the capital N. How can you define mean? It is defined as the number of gram equivalent of the solute present in a liter of solution. Here also taking the what solution, that too in the 1 liter, same as in case of molarity. But here you have to take the number of gram equivalent of solute, not the number of moles. You have to take the number of gram equivalent of solute. Now let us see normality. Capital N equal to number of gram equivalent of solute. You can represent as a NGEW, number of gram equivalent weight of solute, divided with the what volume of solution in liters. Okay, so now let us see here number of, since here number of gram equivalent weight equal to weight by gram equivalent weight. How take the what number of gram equivalent weight equal to weight by gram equivalent weight. Okay, here W indicate what weight of the solute in grams, V nothing but volume of the solution. So since N equal to W by gram equivalent weight, I am going to substitute here instead of NGEW, I am going to substitute what weight by gram equivalent weight into 1 by V in liters. Value we took the liters. If you take the volume again in the ml means you have to, here you have to multiply with the 1000. So weight by gram equivalent weight into 1000 by V in what ml. Okay. So here also you should be very careful. Normality, while calculating normality is the volume given in liters or ml, you should be very careful. Okay, now let us see the example here. Calculate the normality of oxalic acid solution, okay, containing 6.3 grams of oxalic acid. Here this is a formula of oxalic acid, that is H2C2O4 into 2H2O in 500 ml of solution. Okay, so we have the 6.3 grams of oxalic acid dissolved in the what 500 ml of solution given. Okay, now this is the volume of solution. Now what is the amount of solute here? How much we have? 6.3 grams. Volume of solution, how much we have? 500 ml. What we have to calculate here? Normality we have to calculate. Okay. Now, first you have to calculate the gram equivalent weight of oxalic acid. It is what? Here what we have? Gram equivalent weight of solute we have now. Okay. So, you have to calculate the gram equivalent of, number of gram equivalent of solute. So, direct I am taking this formula. So number of gram equivalent weight you can write as a what weight by gram equivalent weight. Simply you remember this formula. Okay, weight by gram equivalent into 1 by V in liters. If it is in given liters, if it is value means you have to multiply it with the 1000. So here so this is the formula we have. We have already mass of the what molar mass of the oxalic acid already we have. That is how much? 6.3 grams. Now what we need here? Gram equivalent weight of oxalic acid we need. Okay, now how we have to calculate the gram equivalent weight of oxalic acid means you have to take the molar mass of oxalic acid divided with the what basicity. Okay, here how this formula came already we discussed in the stoichiometry. Okay, in stoichiometry in the you can see the video concept of equivalent weight. There you already we calculate the equivalent weight of atom, ion, okay, acid, base, salt, oxidizing agent, reducing agent. Okay, now this is the case of acid. Okay, oxalic acid is nothing but already mentioned this acid. For acid we will take the basicity, for the bases we take the acidity. Okay, now this is the acid, so you have to take the molar mass of particular acid divided with the basicity. Now basicity of this oxalic acid 2, why? Because means it can replace the 2 hydrogen atoms. So here molar mass of oxalic acid, how much you are going to get? 126 divided with the what? 2. Okay, basicity 2, why? Because means in oxalic acid 2 hydrogen can going to be replaced. So this is 2 equal to how much you are getting now? Gram equivalent weight, how much you are getting going to get? 63. Okay, now normality equal to weight by gram equivalent weight into 1000 by V ml. I am taking the ml formula, why? Because means here volume of the solution what they given in the ml. Okay, so weight by gram equivalent weight into 1000 by V in the ml. So weight already we how much given? 6.3 grams. Okay, how much you are getting the gram equivalent weight? 63 into 1000 by 500 ml. So if you calculate here, we are getting the 0.N. okay, This is the normality of solution. Yeah, here you can see the in-text question. This is an intermediate secondary test book. In page number, you can go for the page number 39. You can see the based on the whatever we discussed the methods. Based on that, you have 2.1 to 2.5 questions. Okay, just work out that one. Okay, if you do the numericals only, you can understand clearly the concept. Okay, so we discuss the methods of expression concentrations.